Everyone in the world now, all Muslims in the world, news, Facebook, Twitter, people in coffee shops, people over dinner, people over argila, home at night, people having coffee. Every Muslim in the world now, nearly, is talking about Gaza. And to be honest with you, it's a very, very, very disturbing state that the Ummah is in. Because you find a lot of people, my brothers and my sisters, you know, it's very, very sad. It's very sad how shallow the Ummah is. It's very sad how uneducated many people in the Ummah are. It's very, very, very sad how far we are from the Deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. It's very sad. But still people are, you know, sitting, debating, analyzing. Everyone wants to give his opinion, you know. Oh, this is happening. Oh, no, no, this is happening. No, 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 this is happening. If you read the news, you find all the different groups in the Ummah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you know, arguing, fighting, debating, you know, what should we do, what shouldn't we do. People come up with ideas, what should be done, how can we help, how can we this. Inna sa'yakum lashatta. The world, the whole Ummah is divided, you know, there's no clarity. This is why I have to, I find myself obliged to take everyone a step back, okay? Every Muslim, my brothers, like we always say, has to be genuine and honest with himself, okay? I'm gonna say a few things. I know some brothers might get upset. I know some people might, you know, be turned off. But I'm sure in the midst of all what you're watching, all the analysis and all the mashayikh and lectures that you have heard, I'm sure you've heard everything. I'm sure everyone has, you know, heard this opinion and that opinion and that opinion and this opinion and this sheikh analyzing and this brother attacking the mashayikh and this brother attacking his other brother and this group saying the other group are hypocrites and, you know, I'm sure you've heard it all. No one is living in a cave, you know, you don't know what's happening. So what I say at the end of the day is advice for myself and for whoever is listening. At the end of the day, if you don't like it, just add it to the air. Add it to the list of rubbish that you've been hearing and not liking for the past month. You know, it's not, you shouldn't get upset. You know, at the end of the day, it's an opinion. Okay? You accept it, you accept it. You benefit from it, you benefit from it. You don't benefit from it. No hard feelings, you know. We're just one in millions of opinions, mashallah, in the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But if it makes sense to you, maybe, inshallah, by the help of Allah Azza wa Jal, maybe it will give you some clarity about our situation, my brothers. The truth of the matter is, no one, I don't know anyone who really cares about Gaza. I just see hypocrites around me. I don't see anyone that is really, really, you know, Allah, he can't sleep at night because what's happening in Gaza, you know? From mashayikh to brothers to organizations to countries, you know? The truth of the matter is, my brothers, you have to ask yourself this. This Gaza problem, is it a deen problem? Is it a religious problem? Yes. Yes. This Gaza problem, is it a religious problem? Is it a religious war? Is it a religious situation? A religious fight? Or is it just a, you know, like a humanitarian crisis? Millions of people in the world, non-Muslim, no deen, no Allah, no Akhirah, no Jannah, no Jahannam, You know, they just, they've taken the Palestinian side, or you know, they protesting and they saying, where is the humanitarian law? Where is the this? Stop the genocide. Sheely out of humanity, you know? They see the pictures, they see the kids dying, they see the, you know, the videos coming out of Gaza, they hear the news, and they, you know, they get affected emotionally, all right? And for some people, the matter is religious. They say, oh, it's about deen. It's not about humanity, it's about my brother or my sister, you know, being hurt. So, I have a few problems with this. I'm going to share them with you. If your concern about Gaza is sheerly humanitarian, it has nothing to do with deen, I fully respect you. I have no problem with you. If your problem is that, humans are being killed, there's genocide, or there's bombing, or there's this and that, خلاص, you're a human being, you know, you have a good heart, but you're going to Jahannam khalidina fiha abada. You know, the end, your ending religiously from we're in the masjid, we're in the house of Allah, we are, you know, we're not here giving a political lecture or a humanity, we're not in the UN, we're in the masjid, so we speak Quran and Sunnah, we speak deen. And according to deen, these cute people in the world that are humanitarian, they're nice, thank you, you know. You have a good soul, you have a good heart, but where are you going? Don't get upset, you know. You die today, you are going to go to Jahannam, خالدين فيها أبدا. You die on kufr, إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. They are kuffar, they are non-Muslim, they go to Jahannam. If your view of what's happening in Gaza is coming from religious sentiment, the fight between Haqq and Batil, I have a very, very big problem with you. I can't in my heart reconcile your feelings. I can't reconcile your anger. It frustrates me, and I have to say what I understand, you know? The fight between Haqq and Batil, the fight between good and bad, truth and falsehood, religiously, didn't start 1 month ago, did it? Did the war start a month ago? Masjid al-Aqsa has been occupied now since 1948. Did the Muslim brothers wake up 1 month ago and, oh my God, there's a religious problem in Palestine? Now you woke up and now you want to go on Facebook and put the Palestinian flag? Did you just realize that there's a religious fight happening there 1 month ago? Or is it just a wave? Or everyone's, you know, everyone's protesting, everyone's supporting Palestine, so I want to, you know, sa'ab, you know, it's a, where am I going? I have to be, you know, with everyone. I have to wear the kafiyah, and I have to show solidarity, and I have to show, you just realize the problem now? Because if you just realize the problem now, there's a huge problem about your deen. Something is very wrong about you as a Muslim. Something is very wrong about your understanding of deen. If you just realize the problem happened a month ago, there's something very, very, very wrong about how you think. And if you know the problem existed from before, then this trend and vibe, this reactiveness is also concerning. Why, my brothers? And please listen to me carefully, and inshallah, I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make me express this in the best way. My brothers, the law of Allah in dealing with Muslims is very, very, very clear, okay? I'm going to take you back a little bit back in history. Before this ummah came, you know this ummah, the ummah of Muhammad Sallam? Before this ummah came, there was a very, very special ummah called Bani Israel, right? Bani Israel, my brothers, very, very, very similar to our ummah. They're the ones just before us. And their Prophet Musa alayhi salam, the main prophet for Bani Israel is the most prophet mentioned in our Quran. Not for Bani Israel. Allah mentioned Musa alayhi salam in our Quran for who? For us. And this special ummah that Allah testified in the Quran, Allah said to us, Allah is telling us, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحُكْمَ وَالنُّبُوَّةِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah said in our Quran, my brothers and my sisters, that we gave Bani Israel the book, Torah, knowledge, hikmah. We gave them tayyibat, we blessed them so many blessings, and Allah said, and we preferred them over every other nation. وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah is testifying. So what happened to our ancestor? What happened to the guys before us? They disobeyed Allah and betrayed their prophets. They broke the covenant they had with Allah, not once, not twice, multiple times. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in our Quran, Allah, think this with me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told our ummah what happened to the bad student that just came before you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that he cursed them. The prophets cursed them. لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ. Allah said, the prophets of Bani Israel that were sent for their guidance ended up what? Cursing them. لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ. Why, ya Allah? Why were they cursed? Allah is educating this ummah. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. Because of their sin and their transgression. كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَن مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ. The biggest... Allah could have said they fell in zina. Allah could have said they dealt with riba. Allah said the main sin that was the reason this nation was cursed is what? كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَن مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ. When sin appeared amongst them, they did not care about each other. The guy will commit a sin from Bani Israel and everyone will leave him alone. Oh, son of my business, you know, I have my work, I have my life. لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Allah said, what a disgusting act they did. So what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكَ لَيَبْعَثَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ يَسُومُهُمْ سُوءَ الْعَذَابِ. Allah said this. Listen carefully. Allah said that Allah took oath. Allah promises that this nation, Bani Israel, what will happen to them? Allah said, I promise that until the day of Qiyamah, I will keep sending people, I will keep sending aqdar to torture these people, to punish these people. Allah said, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكَ لَيَبْعَثَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ يَسُومُهُمْ سُوءَ الْعَذَابِ. The worst of punishments is coming to these people. Why? Because they disobeyed the prophets of Allah. They were ungrateful and they rejected the deen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them. They were ungrateful to the blessings Allah gave them. So they became punished. Not one ayah, not two ayat. I can spend the whole day with you here explaining to you how many times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned this ummah from making the same mistakes of Bani Israel. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our Prophet came and said what? Ya jama'at al-khair. يا أمة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أو أمة أو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم be careful if you do the same mistakes what's gonna happen my brothers if you do the same mistakes the same the law of Allah does not change قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لتتبعن سنن من كان قبلكم حذو النعل بالنعل you will follow the way of the nations before you step by step even if they enter a lizard soul حتى إذا دخلوا جحر ضب دخلتموه خلفه وقد كان the prophecy of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم happened Islam held itself for a while and then century after century things are getting worse until we reach the state that we are in. This ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, my brothers, despite the khair that it's in, despite the goodness in some people, sin is abundant. Haram is out. It is in the open. It's not hidden. It's everywhere you go. It's every Muslim and non-Muslim country you go. It's every Muslim community you go. Haram is rising to Allah in the millions of sins, in the billions of sins. What does this ummah expect from Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala? Really, really, what do we expect from Allah? Nusra, Rahma, Izzah, Honor. If you think like this, you are definitely using some drugs. Something is wrong with your understanding of deen. You're taking alcohol, you're consuming something. You're not, clearly you don't read the Quran. Allah's fair, my brothers. Allah's just. This ummah is being punished everywhere in the world. Palestine is not an exception. Palestine is a pimple. It's a local disease appearing in a sick body. A body that is frail, that has cancer and AIDS and Ebola. Imagine someone who has 10-20 viruses in his blood. Symptoms appear, you know. Find out his eyes are hurting, his kidneys are collapsing, liver is failing, his legs, something is happening. And then when this patient that has all these diseases sees the symptom, he freaks out. Oh my God, what's happening to my finger? What's happening to your finger, brother? The whole body is collapsing. What's happening to the finger? I've screamed a million times on this minbar. I said, my brothers, this ummah has to return to Allah or else the grinder will keep moving. The punishment of Allah just changes places. Same ummah, same people. There's nothing called Palestinians as nationality. There's something called the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One day it's Kashmir. One day it's Bosnia. One day it's Syria. One day it's Yemen. One day it's Egypt. One day it's Lebanon. One day, soon, Australia. You know? If you are going to be reactive to every single symptom that appears in the body, you have no understanding of how deep the problem of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is. Listen to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carefully. Listen carefully to the words of the teacher that Allah sent to educate us. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Bukhari, إِذَا تَبَايَعْتُمْ بِالْعِينَ If you start dealing with riba, alright? Ina is not any riba. Ina is manipulative riba. If you know what Ina is, it's a type of contract that is basically riba, but it's one of those, you know, bypassing, you know? It's like a detour. It's riba. At the end of the day, it's riba, but it's detour. Hidden in the look, in a image of a halal contract, but really it is riba. I know it's riba. The guy buying from me knows it's riba exactly. Say, oh, we're not doing riba, we're doing عينة. You know? قال صلى الله إذا تبايعتم بالعينة. Do you see عينة around you everywhere? You know? Now we don't see عينة. Before it was, you know, Now, open first house, second house, third house. Some people say, brother, there's no riba in the non-Muslim countries. Brother, ah, not the Dar al-Harb, you know. The Ummah of Muhammad Sallam in Egypt, in Saudi Arabia, in Qatar, in the UAE, the heart of the Muslim Ummah, all the systems are riba systems. Open. All right. إذا تبايعتم بالعينة وأخذتم أذناب البقر. أخذتم أذناب البقر يعني إيه؟ يعني you grabbed onto cow's tails. يعني you became farmers. خدت أذناب البقر يعني خلاص we everyone's a farmer. A farmer خلاص he's ما شاء الله بيزع حتة الأرض بتاعته. He has a piece of land. ضيعة you know ما شاء الله he's farming, he's growing. وأخذتم أذناب البقر ورضيتم بالزرع. And you are content with farming and cultivation and dunya. You're an engineer, you're an accountant, you're a lawyer, you're living a nice life, mashallah. It's all about dunya, it's all about money and money making and upgrading your lifestyle. These are the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you start dealing with عينة and you take the cow tails and you are content with farming, وَتَرَقْتُمُ الْجِهَادِ and you leave the struggle to establish the deen of Allah on earth, what will happen? These are not my words. This is a law mentioned 1400 years ago. I don't know why this. Maybe the Ummah doesn't want to know. They don't want to hear it. What will happen? He is telling us what will happen. قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ صَلَّطَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ ذُلًّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send on you such humiliation. لا ينزعه حتى ترجعوا إلى دينكم. And this humiliation, this ذل, will never ever be lifted unless and until you go back to your deen. There is no two ways about it, my brothers. Anyone who wants to become reactive about a new problem, any new symptom of the main disease in the Ummah that appears everywhere in the world, is clearly not in the fight in the first place. You don't understand what's happening. What's happening, my brothers and my sisters, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing this Ummah left, right and center. Because of what? Because this Ummah left its deen. Because the houses of Allah are empty. Because sin happens openly. Because women have taken off their hijab and have shown their awrat, and the youth men at home, the men that have no ghira, don't mind it. Every single sin that rises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from as east as New Zealand and Australia to as west as America, mashallah. Every single sin that rises to Allah, think of this. Think a Google, you know, view. How much sin is rising from the Muslim countries, from Muslim people, my brothers. Every sin that rises brings down what? Musibah. قال سبحانه وتعالى وما أصابكم من مصيبة فبما كسبت أيديكم ويعفو عن كثير. Allah forgives a lot, but still you have to taste the result of your sin to wake up. حتى ترجعوا إلى دينكم. So anyone that thinks, anyone that's so superficial, that thinks, oh brother, this is a local problem, it's only, you know, it's only a problem in Palestine. Brother, where have you been? Where have you been, my brother? The problem is not Palestine. The problem is everywhere in the world. The problem is every single place in the world. Actually, if you have proper understanding of deen, I'm sorry to say this, Palestine, Gaza especially, is one of the happy places. From a religious point of view, from a deeny point of view, if this is really what's burning you, what's happening in Gaza is a breath of fresh air. Why? I don't know if you have visited Gaza before. Alhamdulillah, Allah bless me, I visited Gaza, you know. Australians have no idea what it means like to live a life where any second, you know, any second, any day, you can wake up in the morning and find that you and your family are gone. We don't know this feeling, you know. In Australia, yesterday, I think, Optus, the coverage stopped for a few hours. Yeah, haram, people were panicking, falling on the street, you know. People called the police, people went to the police station, you know. How are we going to live? You know. Few hours, no mobile phone, and the country nearly collapsed. You don't know what it means to live under fire 24/7. When you go see these people, and still, I have to be honest, don't think everyone in Gaza, be honest, don't think everyone in Gaza is pious and everyone in Palestine is religious. There's also haram and there's also sin and there's also corruption. But to a certain extent, because they live under the threat of death every day, definitely speaking, they are much, much more religious than many, many, many people, Muslims in the world nowadays. Many Muslim people in the world, they are in the top, mashallah, 10%, I would say. They have deen, they have akhirah, they make dua, their masajid are full. Hufaz of Quran are abundant. Women, it is nearly, is very, very, very rare to go in Gaza and find a lady not covered properly. Very rare. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jal blessed them with this test. He knows there's not much to live. He knows maybe tomorrow I'll die, you know. There's no comfort, there's no luxury. There's definitely a high level of fear of Allah there. So from a religious perspective, why are you so cut? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting shuhada. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is blessing them. This person that dies, you know, if he's good, if he's a good Muslim, he's going straight to Jannah. Why does a Muslim get upset? Muslims don't get upset when people go to Jannah. Muslims get upset when they see in Saudi Arabia, maybe 50 kilometers away from the Kaaba, big now, mashallah, ceremonies and parades, and the most famous celebrities, 50 kilometers away from the Kaaba, the most famous celebrities, fasad, corruption, the icons of kufr and ilhad are being paraded. Anyone making qunut for Saudi? Did you see any Muslim at night, wallah, I can't sleep, bilad al-haramain, we need to make dua? I didn't see anyone making dua for Dubai. I didn't see anyone making dua for the Muslims that are lost in Australia. People don't care. Do you know how much haram is happening in Australia, brother? Do you know how much fasad is happening here? Or are you unaware? Do you know how many Muslims in the world are gay, homosexual now? Are you aware of what's happening in the world? Or are you completely oblivious of this too? The truth of the matter is that our concern is not religious. Our concern is also like these humanitarians, you know? When someone dies, I feel, you know, wallah, the pictures are very, very disturbing. So what's the solution? What do we do? Instead of following the law of Allah, okay, that's a big slap, ya Allah. All right, ya Allah, we understand. We get the message, ya Allah. Inshallah, as an ummah, we're gonna, you know, return to Allah, repent to Allah, come back to Allah, come back to jihad fi sabilillah, come back to da'wah, come back to tahajjud, repent to Allah from our sin. No, we won't do this. Muslims in the world are doing two things now. And please, if you don't like what I say, again, like I said, please don't get offended, don't get upset. The majority of Muslims are doing two things now. One of them is more disgusting than the other. They're both very disgusting, but one is like very disturbing, you know. Many Muslims who I personally know, I know them personally, I'm not talking about people that I don't know, so no one can say, oh brother, have husna dhan, maybe another. We're not done, all right? Many Muslims that I know him personally, no salah in the masjid, no deen, no akhirah, no Quran, nothing. His life is full of sin. And then all of a sudden this happened and he became the biggest Palestinian case. Allah, he's an activist now. And he wants to, he wants to call out the people that have been working for deen for years while he was disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal. He wants to call, brothers, and be active. The Palestinian cause, mashallah, you have to, speak out. So one group is this. It's all about Facebook, Twitter, I don't want to say something bad, but if you're on Facebook, if you have a Facebook account, I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry, but this means you're on the other side. You're on the forces of the bottom, my brother. If you are on Facebook, if your wife is on Facebook, something is wrong with your deen. If you can't see this, we have a long way to go, my brother. If you think that this is how we're going to solve the problem by mashallah wearing a kafiya or putting the Palestinian flag, if this is how you see is the solution to our problem, you need religious education. And worse than these people are the people that believe in the system of kufr. Wal'iyadu billah. Some people, they're that foolish. I don't know where they live. They live with us on this planet, or they live on Mars or another planet. They still believe the system of kufr. So they say what? Brother, we have to, our voices have to reach authorities. Brother, are you with us on this same earth? Brother, we have, every Muslim has to, go and imagine, my brothers and ummah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created to be the leaders of the world. And now his best endeavor, his best effort, he claims that the best effort required to do is to go to the non-Muslim oppressor and say to him, please follow the UN regulations. Please, where is humanity? Where is the human in you? Because they actually believe the system. Like, they believe in democracy. They believe that if enough Muslims rise, Australia, for example, as a country, will change its foreign policy. I don't know if these people actually know what's happening. Or Habibi, Australia, just for your information, I don't want to talk politics. I'm not a politician. I'm going to say what everyone in the world knows. Australia has no foreign policy. Australia, like many, many other countries in the world, like Egypt, like Saudi Arabia, like all these Arab countries, they cannot go against America. They can't afford. This world order that we have is a world order of a bully. It's a result of a world war. A war happened, all right? Maybe you were too young, I don't know, you don't read history. A war happened and some countries came on top and they made the laws. They set the system. They divided the booty, They made this UN. They said, if you want to be a country in the world, if you want to be a country, you have to come to this organization and we have to accept that you are a country. If you're not, you're not even a country in our books. They made the, whatever called Majlis al Amn, I don't know what the name is in English, this council, whatever. we're veto. Everyone can discuss. Imagine we're sitting in a meeting, 10 countries, for example. Everyone can say his opinion. You're allowed to say, we are good people. We hear every opinion. You're allowed to say any opinion you want. But if we say veto, what happens? What happens? Then it's veto. Then it's, خلاص, يا عبيتو انت, go. Get out of here, خلاص. This is the system we live in. If you really think we have freedom of choice and this and that, ya haram, you fell prey to mass media brainwashing. You think, oh, if enough Muslims get up, mashallah, whatever the prime minister name is now, he will change his opinion. And you know, masalan, say, oh, we're against Israel now. I don't know, Allah al-Azim. What drug are you concealing? I don't know what it is. But imagine that this is how weak the ummah is. Instead of us repenting to Allah and returning to Allah and seeking forgiveness from Allah, returning to Allah so Allah Azza wa Jal can bring this ummah back to its honor. No. We want to have a mixed protest where men and women, mashallah, women, some women without hijab. Imagine your sister is without hijab saying, free, free, Palestine. And all men are saying, mashallah, alaykum al-ruh. Good on you, sister. Wallahi, you're a soldier. You are better than the mashayikh. You are better than the ulama, sister. Because you're speaking out against oppression. Speaking out against who are you speaking to? I want to know who they're speaking to. Who are you speaking to? Who? Do you think these Western countries don't know what's happening, yani? They have no intelligence. They have no mukhabara. Oh, they don't. Haram. No. They say this. We have to show them what's happening in Gaza because they don't know.
Spread away.
Spread away. Oh, they don't know what's happening in Gaza. You live on this world or not? Imagine this is how weak the ummah is. Instead of returning to Allah, no. We are going to go in a mixed protest. Maybe 10,000 Muslims will miss Salah in the masjid again. You know? Women no hijab, women with hijab. And then by every guy that wants to... may Allah forgive us all. You know, Allah a'lam bin nawaya. Allah knows the intentions. Everyone that wants to show a bit of... I want to show I'm in solidarity with my brothers. So I'm going to stand, give a very, very amazing sermon. I will scream and I will shout and I will show how much, mashallah, I care about Palestine. And then after the protest, inshallah, we all go back home and have a barbecue, afshawi, you know, together, you know, and maybe miss Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, you know. I'm not saying everyone is like this, but I'm saying to you, this effort, I need to understand, what are you trying to do? Let's say, for example, the 1 million Australians, let's say the 1 million Muslims in Australia, they all go to a protest. Do you reckon the rest of Australia is going to wake up in the morning and say, you know what? There's 1 million Muslims protesting, you know, we should change our foreign policy. We should tell America, khalas, we're not your ally anymore. We will, you know, we don't want your support. We don't want your protection. We don't want your nuclear submarines that we paid billions of dollars for. We want to, you know, sever. Because we have one Muslims, Australians upset. You reckon that's what's going to happen, brother? Is that what you're aiming for, sister? What are you thinking? Habibi, if you think it's a religious war, you have to understand. It's a religious war. It's a war of masalih, benefits. Israel was planted there in this area specifically by the same countries you are trying to beg from. They fool you. Oh yeah, come, I'm going to listen to you. Wallah, I want to hear your opinion, please. Your opinion is very valuable to me. Please say your opinion. What do you think we should do? No, genocide. Few media shows and a few talk shows and that and finished. Because you think a haram, they don't know. They know. They are supporting, they are approving, they are sending weapons, they are sending military, full support. Like when 9/11 happened, you know, when 3,000 Americans were killed in one day, no country in the world put the American flag. Australia didn't put the American flag on the Opera House. America, the boss. When the boss was bombed, no one put the American flag on the Opera House. Or maybe it happened, I can't remember. You know? Oh, it wasn't the whole of the thing, wasn't there yet, sah? 2001. You know? Now, khalas. Next day, every country in the world, France, why? Because you have to understand how the world works. The only ally of the Muslims now is who? Putin. Have you seen this one? Russia came out and said, Wallah, the Palestinians are being oppressed. Do you know what? Because we are just proxy wars. You know proxy? Our area,
our land is so stupid. It's so not in the game at the moment. We are so humiliated. The major superpowers of the world, they fight on our land. That's all. They don't want to hit each other because they have very, very strong nuclear bombs, you know? So what do? Instead of me slapping you and you slapping me, I will slap your guy and you slap my guy. That's it. That's all what's happening. You are a daltool, you are a puppet, and you're being slapped. That's all. That's all what's happening in the world now. If you can't see it and you think, wallah, no, I'm going to tell the UN. The guy from the UN, I don't know his name, is Guterres, whatever, something. He came out and said, very, very subtle. He goes, what's happening is, you know, very bad. Wallah, the Israeli said to him, look, I should leave your position. You should retire. But Muslims still believe, no, we have to lobby and we have to spread awareness and we have to... Ya haram, an ummah of humiliation. So some people, ya haram, believe in the system. They still trust the system and they think, wallah, we can lobby and negotiate and deal with politicians, and the politicians, inshallah, will, you know, Allah, it's beyond me. And some people, I believe it's, yani, it's very, very, very sad. It's a very, very sad situation. It's very, very sad what's happening, that even the ones who want to do something, who feel guilty, the best understanding of what should happen is that we should, you know, all go out together and sing, you know, hold hands, Muslim, non-Muslim, and make like some sort of vigil, you know, and maybe sing the Palestinian anthem or something, and, you know, now we're gonna make a change in the world. Anyway, people can disagree. People can say, no, brother, wallah, you're wrong. These people are sincere, and they try, may Allah reward them if they are sincere. Jazahumullah khair. But I know for a fact that protests, if you think protests are going to do something, you don't understand what's happening in the world. And if you think that you posting Palestine on Facebook and, you know, wallah, you're creating awareness and this and that, again, may Allah reward you for your good intention, but that's not what's needed. What's needed is this. Listen to me carefully. He'll say, Ash, what do we do? I'll tell you what's needed. What's needed, my brothers and my sisters, is for the ummah to return to Allah. Nothing is going to change until the majority of the ummah returns to Allah. There's no quick solution. If someone thinks, oh, what can I do now? There's no now. There's nothing called now. The ummah needs to be rebuilt. The ummah needs to collectively come back to the deen of Allah. If they don't, do whatever you want. Go and put any bandage on the local disease. Any bandage you want. You know, anything you do, it's not going to work. Because the blood is full of poison. The body is frail. The body is dying. It's not a local problem. All right, Iraq, Syria, millions died. Millions are dying with no deen, you know? Haram is happening everywhere in the world. No one cares. No one is bothered. No one is making qunut for Saudi Arabia. No one cares while Gaza is being bombed. There was Muslim Riyadh happening. Dancing and, you know, whatever. Partying. No one really is worried about Saudi Arabia. We're worried about Palestine, you know? No one. The truth is, my brothers and sisters, we don't really care. If you really care, he's the only solution. There's no other solution. There's no half solutions. There's no quick solutions. The only way this bala is going to be lifted is if the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam returns to Allah. How does the ummah, this is the question you need to ask. How can the ummah return to Allah? Well, very, very simple. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to this ummah in a much, much worse situation. 360 idols were being worshipped in the Kaaba. Imagine, other than the Kaaba, the symbol of Tawheed, had 360 idols worshipped other than Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started the effort of Anbiya. Allahu waliyyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min al-dhulumati إلى النور.
He started one, the one became two, the two became four, the four became 10, the 10 became 200. And then the deen of Allah spread. And a revolution happened in the ummah that changed the face of earth. No other solution. There is no other way. If you want to help, the sins have to stop. The mashayikh say this, listen carefully. Say, imagine this, my brothers. Imagine there's a swimming pool. Allah will make it easy. Imagine there's a swimming pool. Alright? This swimming pool has an alarm bell. It has an alarm bell. Every time the level of the swimming pool drops, okay? It drops below a certain level, what happens? This alarm bell starts ringing. If I come with a bucket and I take water out of the pool, let's say I go to the eastern side of the pool and I take a bucket out, does only the eastern side get affected? Where does the level drop? In all the pools, صح? All the pool, the level drops. Someone else comes on the north side of the pool, it takes another bucket, what happens? Level drops. I'm taking from here, you're taking from there, sin is happening here, haram is happening there. The level of iman drops, 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 it hits a certain level, alarm bells ring and punishment comes from Allah. It doesn't matter where. This is the design of Allah Azza wa Jal. Where Allah hits, where Allah punishes, which tsunami, look at Libya, Morocco, before that Turkey, it's happening everywhere. Our turn is coming soon. Don't hold your breaths. You know, India is coming very soon. Modi is coming after you, you know. Indians are happy, oh, we're safe, alhamdulillah, democracy. Modi is coming after you very soon, you know. South Africa, people say, the black South Africans are going to come after them very soon. Everywhere in the world, my brothers, anyone who is watching can see. Each community, every Muslim is not safe as long as sins are rising to Allah. Today you're watching the news, tomorrow you will be the news. Today you're watching Palestinian children, tomorrow it will be your children. There's no difference. We're all one ummah, there's no nationalities. Sin rises, bala descends. And the same happens with the pool. Anyone, my brothers, who grabs some water and pours it in the pool, where does the level rise? Only where he poured the water? Everywhere. Every Muslim that comes back to Allah, returns to Allah, and helps others around him to return to Allah is helping the Ummah of Muhammad Sallam revive. And every single Muslim who is committing sin, every young man who is watching haram at night, no one can see him. No mother, no father, no brother, no wife, alone at night, you know, he turned on the internet and he's watching haram at night. This sin, Uqsim billah, this sin has an effect on Palestine, Syria, Yemen, Australia. Your sin rises and it all comes together, you know? And bala then descends by the qadr of Allah. Today Pakistan, tomorrow Australia, after this Indonesia. No one, Allah's grinder is working. You want to help the Ummah of Muhammad Sallam, then you have a job that you return to Allah and you make others return to Allah. The more you do, the better. Any other, Allah, brother, no, we want to, you know, I don't know, lobby who, or talk to who, or express to who, or, you know. People are saying, alhamdulillah, I heard one brother saying, MashaAllah, look at, you know, Twitter. Twitter is the only social media something that is allowing, you know, all content from Gaza and Palestine. What a good man Elon Musk is, you know, he's a good Muslim soldier. Same thing, he's mujahid fi sabilillah. Brother, the guy just bought Twitter, ya haram, and he wants more customers. He wants to get more customers. He goes, yalla, let's use this opportunity. Let the Muslims get happy, you know. If you think lobbying and politics and this is going to change anything, no problem. That's your opinion. Jazakallah khair. Continue. But I'm telling you now, wallahi, if all of us protest, it will not change anything in the world. And all of you who are saying, even the Muslims that are saying, I don't know where the Arab armies are. What Arab armies? Are you in La La Land? Are you on a different planet? What Arab armies? The Egyptian army, you know, the Egyptian army, people saying, oh, why isn't Egypt getting involved? The Egyptian army
has been funded by the American country for the past 70 years. America gives the Egyptian army $1 billion every year. Two billion. Imagine America is giving him $2 billion every year after 70 years. He's gonna come and say, oh yeah, America, let's go to war. Let's go to war. Your weapons are American. Your planes are American. Your training programs are American. The whole country's American. We don't even know how to make our own weapons. Allah, why isn't Saudi Arabia bombing Israel? Saudi bombing Israel. Are you? Where are you? Oh, they should do something. Brother, our countries are occupied. Our countries are all occupied. I don't know what you're thinking. Hey, brother, if you really care religiously about Palestine and every other problem in the world, please, for the sake of Allah, start with yourself. And then work tirelessly with those around you. If we manage, imagine Sydney really, the Muslims of Sydney really come together. Say to our people, brother, alhamdulillah, we all united, alhamdulillah. We all want to make a change. Imagine all the, you know, my sheikh used to say this. My sheikh used to say, imagine he had a dream, you know. It was, imagine if one day, just one day, all Muslims in Egypt pray Fajr in the mosque. Just imagine, you know, Egypt has 90 million Muslims, you know. Let's say half are women and children. Imagine if 40 million Muslims prayed Fajr in the mosque. What would happen in Israel? It's a religious war, my brother. You know? Very, very famous saying. In Israel, they say, yes. They say, don't worry about these Muslims. As long as the number of Musallin in Jum'ah is more than the number of Musallin in Fajr, don't worry. We are safe. When should we get scared? When do we worry? We worry when the Muslims in Fajr are equal. When you come to Masjid al-Nur and find people praying outside in Fajr Salah, then worry. Then, you know, then the Ummah is going to do something. But before this, Allah, protest, sing, dance, go make, you know, protest all day, all night. Every Muslim, wear a kafiyah. Every Muslim, mashallah, make a Palestinian tattoo or hang a Palestinian flag. Wallahi al-Azim, nothing will change. Because you are not with us on this earth. If you want, there's only one system. There's only one system. Allah says this, listen carefully. Allah says this, I'm going to finish, khalas. Qala subhanahu wa ta'ala, listen. Wa'ad Allah, Allah's promise, Allah's qasam. وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات. Allah promises those who have belief and iman. وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم. Allah will make them the kings of earth. That's not my promise. Allah's promise in the Quran. Like Allah made the nations before them control earth, Allah will make them control of earth. ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم. And Allah will make Islam dominant. وليبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا. And Allah will change their fear into safety. How? يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا. They worship Allah properly. They work in da'wah properly. They sacrifice properly. They live by the deen of Allah properly. They care about other people in the ummah properly. When this ummah starts doing the work of anbiya, my brothers, then and only then will you make a change. Other than this, I'm telling you now, you want to go on protests, go. May Allah reward you. You want to go on Facebook, you want to go on YouTube and make a video for awareness, may Allah reward you. Jazakallah khair for your good attention, go. You want to lobby the UN, you want to take the UN to court, you want to do whatever you're doing, do it. But I'm telling you now, nothing's going to change. Same system, Allah's design does not change. It doesn't change. There's only one system.
Return to Allah, Nusra of Allah comes. Away from Allah, punishment of Allah descends. Look at the Ummah and you have all the answers around you. All of us ready, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lift the bala from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help everyone that's suffering in Palestine, Gaza, brothers and sisters, the innocent people that are being butchered and tortured. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lift the suffering and pain. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us real worry and concern about the iman in the ummah and the sins in the ummah and our brothers and sisters in the ummah that can make us change our life, return to Allah properly, work together properly to bring the deen of Allah azza wa jal back again up. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.